welcome back to our channel. Guys, I feel so much better. Thank you for your prayers. I'm still a little under the weather, but I feel like 90% better from yesterday and this past week. So today I'm going to do a Friday's Jack Daniel's. I got a half slab rib, half slab ribs, French fries, and coleslaw. And I'm gonna say the prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this food. We ask God that you bless, that it would nourish our bodies and that it would digest well. In Jesus' name, amen. Guys, today is Friday. Thank God it is Friday. It's been a long week. But as I'm eating on today, I want to talk about something that's very important that affects our society as a whole. I want to talk about breaking bad behaviors within the family. I'm gonna go ahead and start eating while I'm talking. You know, anytime you grow up in a household, and I'll use me as an example, anytime you grow up in a household, I always say a worldly household, where you live with an alcoholic, live with an abuser. I grew up with the alcoholic stepdad who consistently beat my mom, who would curse me and my brother out consistently. And this started when I was probably 4 years old, four or five, something like that. And so we grew up our entire lives until my mom passed away in dysfunction, right? In behaviors that affected me and that affected my brother as we became adults. Behaviors, sometimes you repeat some of those behaviors. I know for myself, I grew up very angry. The least little thing you did to me, I was ready to fight. And it wasn't until my mid-20s where I realized that that's not who I was created to be. That's who I had become. And I had become that as a result of the behaviors that I was exposed to growing up. And so at that point in my life, that's when I gave my life to Christ. And I remember crying out, asking the Lord to change me. I did not want to be that person that I had become. And that environment was toxic, right? Up until I left, my mom passed away from cancer at the age of 50. And I do believe it was because of all of the stress. So as you go through the process of allowing the Lord to change your life, you really have to unlearn all of those behaviors. And so I had to learn how to be a functional adult without repeating those behaviors. I've been to counseling, and the counselors were awesome. Also, I read the word, and I fed on the word, and I believed the word, because the word tells us to be transformed. It's Romans, I believe it's 12:2, to be transformed by the renewing of your mind. And so as I renewed my mind in the word daily, every single day, over time, I saw the change in me. And this is what people don't understand. When you are unlearning bad behaviors, it does not happen overnight. It's like starting off as a newborn baby, learning how to live right. Learning how to live right and learning how to do things differently and learning how to break those curses. And so that didn't happen overnight for me. It's been a process. That process started for me 22 years ago. And I am still unlearning behaviors. I see where, God broke the generational curse of anger and the generational curse of fighting. And I see how I made sure that I didn't pass those bad behaviors down to my children. And growing up, we were exposed to so much. And so I wanted to make sure that I protected my children and make sure that they weren't exposed to those things. And so I am still going through that process. But praise God, I am not that person who I had become. I knew that God didn't create me to be that way. I knew it was as a result of what I grew up in. And I have fought and I am still fighting to make sure that those curses and those bad behaviors are not passed down to my children and my generations. And I'm so grateful that my children are total opposite of what I was. I'm so grateful that through praying and spending time in the Word, and I even would read books about how to be in relationship with your children and how to raise your children the godly way. And I would listen to just radio programs on Moody, children's programs. I would make sure that they were in the Word and make sure they wrote about what they read, and that we sat together almost every day and we talked about what they read, and I allowed them to be themselves explaining to me what they read. But I said all that to say that God is so amazing, to where if you really seek Him and you really want to change and you want your generations to change, the one that created you is the only one that can do that. Now, you have to do the work. You have to do the other stuff. It's a process. And so I just wanted to encourage people, especially young moms who have grown up in abuse, whether it's verbal, whether it's emotional, whether it was a result of molestation, whatever it was. I just want to encourage those young ladies to say, if you are willing to put in the work and take the first step to make sure that that's not passed down to your children, and to make sure that your generations are healthy and they're living out healthy behaviors. Also, too, I want to talk about the importance of being in relationship with your children. The most important relationship that you can have is your relationship with God and then with your children. In order for me to have a healthy relationship with God, I have to spend time with Him. In order for me to have a healthy relationship with my children, I have to spend time with them. I have to want to spend time with them. And if I don't have a heart for wanting to spend time with my children and wanting to build those relationships, then I need to go back and I need to ask the Lord, the one that created you, why is it I can't connect with my children? Or why is it that the only way of communication is yelling at them or being disrespectful to them? Because unfortunately, that's a part of our culture, where we yell at our children and we don't sit down and talk to them and listen to them. And so if I am that mom or I am that dad where I don't know how to connect with my children, then just say a prayer and say, Lord, I don't know why I can't connect, or I don't know why I don't want that relationship, but Lord, help me in that area of learning how to be in relationship. And if it's something in my heart, soften in my heart where I'm not yelling or I'm not attacking, but I learn how to be in a healthy, whole relationship, finding out the things that they're interested in, whether they're little children or even if they're adults. It's never too late. If we make mistakes as parents all the time, But God is so awesome. It's that forgiveness is available every day. And so even though we've made mistakes, we have to be honest and acknowledge and say, hey, I messed up. I didn't know how to talk to you. I didn't know how to treat you. I didn't know how to connect with you. But I would like to learn how to do that. And children are open. Sometimes they may be a little leery to watch to see if you're genuine. But if you give it time and you continue to pursue that relationship, I guarantee you and I promise you that things will change as a result of you being sincere and genuine, wanting to change so that you can build those relationships with them. And when I talk about society, we don't want to put angry children in society. We don't want to put fighting children in society, hurting, wounded children in this society. We want to make sure that when our children go out in the world, that they're healthy, that they're whole, that they love themselves. And as a result of loving themselves, it's what we've poured into them as a result of spending time with them. And so mom and dad, we don't get it right all the time. But thank God that every day that we wake up, we get another chance to get it right. Also, I want to talk about be leery of people who take advantage of your hurt and your wounds. And I'm just talking about the children. Be aware of people who are not sincerely trying to help you, but have a narcissistic personality to where they want you to follow them and they want you to worship them. And so they will come after you and pretend like they're for you and pretend like they want to help you. But in actuality, they just want you to follow them to lift them up because they're still insecure on the inside. And so I suggest to that young person to really seek God, again, your creator, get counseling, seek therapy from somebody that's going to help you become the person that you were created to be, because you were not created to be wounded. You were not created to be hurt. You were not created to be dysfunctional. You were not created to be angry. You are a child of the Most High God. You are a child of a loving God. And God don't even treat us that way. So why would we treat our children that way? God is so loving. He's so kind. He's so patient. Read the fruits of the Spirit. I believe it's Galatians 5th chapter. I'm not sure what verse. But read the fruits of the Spirit. God is all of that: kind, patient, loving, gentle, compassionate. And so that's how we're supposed to be towards our children. And that's how we're supposed to be towards each other. And if I am not that, then I need to acknowledge where I am. And I need to ask God for help. Ask him to change my life. I think this is so important because you have these hurting children who have nobody. That child whose parent who chooses, or parents who chooses not to do the right thing, who chooses not to be in relationship, that's okay. That means that you're the generational curse breaker. That means that you are the one to break that curse. You are the one to do things differently. For myself, sometimes you have to stand alone. I've had people say, you think you're better than us. No, I don't think I'm better than you. I just want better for my life and I want better for my children. So I just wanted to share that. It was so on my heart. You guys have a blessed, blessed Friday. I know I haven't eaten my food. I try to eat a little bit before I end this video. But whenever I upload on my phone, I only have 15 minutes. So, guys, I love you. Have a blessed, blessed Friday. These ribs are really, really good. I love you. Talk to you guys soon. Be encouraged.